G'day scientists, today we're going to be reviewing not one, but two STEM kits. Both of these are from my recent mega shop at ALDI for STEM kits. As usual, I'm going to be rating each one on fun, what you learn while you're playing, and price. And I'll let you know whether I think you should buy them. So we've got the National Geographic Dino Fossil Dig Kit and the Dinosaur Factivity Kit. First up, the Dinosaur Factivity Kit. It cost me $8.99 from ALDI. It's a 10-piece skeleton model to build. I think it's a stegosaurus. Let me know in the comments below if you know what kind of dinosaur this is. Also, it has a book that contains over 400 facts and activities. On the back, a bit more information, but let's get stuck in and open the kit. Opening up, super easy. What have we got in here? It's a bag of dinosaur parts. And looks like the instructions for building the dinosaurs too. Then we've got the book. The book looks thick and it's got a lot of pages in it. What else do we have in here? Ah, the vest of the skeleton, which is inside a plastic display box. Let's open it up and take the pieces out. They're plastic, but have this really nice textured paint on them. It feels lovely. Okay, nothing else inside the box. Let's take a closer look at the book. I can see mazes and puzzles and lots of bright, colourful illustrations. Little quizzes that are spread out through the book too. Let's get on and build this dinosaur. Open up the bag and take the rest of the pieces out. We've got a leg, another leg, part of the head, the tail, part of the body, another leg, and a piece of jaw. Right, let's try and follow the instructions and build this thing. The instructions are tough. What is that piece? Which bit of body should I be using? Is it this one? I know I have to fit a leg in. Does the tail fit in here? Ah, there are holes on the back here. Oh, let's try without the instructions. I can see the body fits together like this. Ah, I got a leg in, great. Another leg. And I can see that the holes are different sizes, so you can't get the legs in the wrong holes. That's good. Ah, tail fits like this. It's starting to come together. Okay, the other side of the body now. One leg here, another leg in this hole. Now the head. I can see the jaw fits on somehow. Ah, it clicks in here. And the side of the head. Done. Head looks good. Now let's attach the head to the ball joint on its body part. Oops, I nearly snapped off that ball joint. It is super fragile. Ah, I see the head needs to be in place on the ball joint before you snap the two parts together. Let's do that very carefully so that I don't break it completely. There, done. Now the head can move around on the body. Final part, let's attach the other body part on. And it's complete. One dinosaur, moving head and moving jaw. Also moving legs, but they're a bit stiff. Let's take another look at that book. It really did look quite good. There is buckets to do in here. Okay, next STEM kit. The National Geographic Dino Fossil Dig Kit, $14.99 from ALDI2. It's got a T-Rex tooth replica inside that you excavate and some dinosaur poop. On the back, it's got some information and a list of what's inside the box. Let's open it up. Cool, we've got the book on the top and a cardboard container underneath. The book is super short, like probably only 10 pages, and some of them are blank for you to write notes on. This must be the dig kit brick that's got the T-Rex tooth inside. There's a little plastic bag that has inside a scraper thingy. A magnifying glass made of plastic. Another plastic bag. And a brush. And here it is, the moment you've all been waiting for, especially my nephew Eddie, the dinosaur poop. It has a little stand so you can put it on display. It's inside this plastic dome, so you can't really take it out. Does it smell? No, it doesn't smell. Nope, no smell detectable. Okay, let's get the instructions for this dig kit. It says it gets messy and it might be best to do it outside. Whatever, we're gonna do it inside and see how messy we get. The specimen is buried inside the digging brick and we need to use the tools to dig it out. If the brick is too hard, we can soften it with some water first. When you do find the specimen, be gentle, otherwise you might damage it. Don't try to pry it out, or you might break it. Last of all, rinse it in water to clean up. The rest of the book looks dull. Let's get started. Unwrap this digging brick. And here it is. Now let's get digging. Get the scraper tool and start scraping. It comes away quite easily, so I know I'm not going to need that water. Ooh, I think I found something. Let's get the brush. Yes, there it is, the start of the tooth. Keep digging around it now and brushing bits away every now and then. While I'm digging and scraping, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notify bell so that you will be alerted when a new video drops. I know it said not to, but I can't help it. I'm gonna pry. Oh, it came out. Cool. Here it is, the tooth. Let's clean it up a bit with a brush. Yep, this is going to need water to clean up. I'm definitely going to need to clean up this desk too, though we're not wrong. There are bits of this plaster everywhere on the desk, on the floor, in the air. This is definitely an outside activity. I'm back, all cleaned up. It wasn't that bad, but I wouldn't do this inside if I were you. I have a bowl of water to clean up this tooth. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Oh, it's got a pattern on it too, and ridges and detail. It looks pretty good. It's got a bit of a detail on it. You can see the seam where it's been in the cast, but overall quite good. We have two kits from ALDI, a battle of the dinosaurs. But which one would I buy again? First up, the Dinosaur Factivity Kit, $8.99. The dinosaur was quite cute to build, but the instructions were really, really bad. The book, however, is excellent. So much to do in it and really nicely illustrated. I'm going to give the Dinosaur Factivity Kit from ALDI 2 stars for fun, 3 stars for price, and 2 stars for learning. Buy or buy-buy? It's a buy. This is really good value for money and will keep the scientists entertained for a long time. Next, the National Geographic Dino Fossil Kit from ALDI, $14.99. I was surprised. Digging out the fossil was actually quite good fun, but it's not something you can do again. The dinosaur poop was a bit of an anticlimax, to be honest. Wouldn't it be more fun if it was scratch and sniff? This book is really poor. It's very boring and there's hardly anything to do in it. I am going to give the National Geographic Dino Fossil Kit from ALDI 2 stars for fun, 1 star for price, and 1 star for learning. Buy or bye-bye? Bye-bye. Mildly amusing, but just not worth the money. If you haven't seen it yet, watch this video.